In today's video, we are going to be talking about insulin resistance and how you can test your insulin sensitivity at home. Insulin resistance has become an epidemic. It is estimated that over 80% of Americans currently have insulin resistance, although the vast majority of these cases go undiagnosed. Insulin resistance is the driving force behind most modern-day diseases, including type 2 diabetes, heart disease, and dementia. Over 90% of people with high blood pressure are insulin resistant, and when these people improve their insulin sensitivity, their blood pressure improves as well. If we can know that we are insulin resistant sooner, we can take steps to reverse it and reduce our chance of developing these diseases further down the track. Insulin resistance often gets overlooked because physicians are told to focus on glucose, but insulin resistance can occur long before it significantly impacts our fasting blood glucose. So in today's video, we are going to talk about three at-home methods you can use to get a sense of your insulin sensitivity. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. Before I begin, I want to thank Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. For everything from websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful website and run your business. Head to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate to start your free trial today. Insulin is an important hormone in the body whose main responsibility is clearing the blood of glucose and shuttling it to our cells. Insulin resistance occurs when the cells in our body stop responding to insulin. This results in insulin levels remaining elevated and not being able to return to baseline, which leads to a wide range of complications within the body. Of course, one of these being type 2 diabetes, as insulin is not able to effectively clear the blood of glucose, but that is not the only disease we need to be concerned about. Every cell in the body has an insulin receptor, and all of them respond differently to insulin, which means that insulin affects everything. And this is why it is connected to such a wide range of diseases. Now, there are several signs to watch out for if you think you might be insulin resistant. As I said at the start of this video, high blood pressure is a pretty good indicator. Skin tags, dark skin patches, and extreme thirst are other symptoms. But if you want to test your insulin sensitivity at home, here are some ways you can do that. Weight to height ratio. Okay, I'm going to start off by saying that the only 100% accurate way to test for insulin resistance is to get a blood test with your doctor, and I will go into that a little bit more at the end of this video. But one surprisingly accurate way to figure out if you are insulin resistant is to calculate your waist to height ratio. Take your waist measurement, divide it by your height, and anything over 0.53 is an indicator of insulin resistance. Of course, if your number is higher, you'll be more insulin resistant, and if your number is just over 0.53, you're only in the early stages. The reason that this simple test is so accurate is that abdominal or visceral fat is one extremely common symptom of insulin resistance. When you are insulin resistant, fat does not get stored as it normally should, and ends up accumulating around your organs instead. So if you have a high waist to height ratio, this is a pretty good indicator of insulin resistance. Triglyceride to HDL ratio. If you have a current cholesterol panel, this can be another good way to get a sense of your insulin sensitivity. The numbers that are relevant here are triglycerides and HDL, and your ratio between the two. A ratio under 1.9 is considered optimal, with good insulin sensitivity. A ratio between 2 to 3 indicates some insulin resistance. And a ratio over 3 means that you are very insulin resistant. Now, it is important to note that you need to calculate this ratio in milligrams per deciliter and not millimolars per liter. So make sure to make the conversion first before figuring out your ratio. Blood glucose. Another way to get a sense of your insulin sensitivity at home is using a blood glucose meter. This test can also be performed by your doctor, and it is called the oral glucose tolerance test. To start off, you want to measure and record your fasting blood sugar. Now you need to consume 75 grams of sugar. No fat, no protein, just sugar. Some options here are about 5 tablespoons of honey or 6 tablespoons of maple syrup. Check the label on whatever you are using and try to get as close to 75 grams as possible. And now wait. You're gonna need to just hang out and chill for the next couple of hours. Don't do any exercise or anything stressful because both of those things can impact your blood sugar as well. 30 minutes after you've consumed the sugar, measure and record your blood sugar again. If you do see a significant rise here, don't freak out. That's totally normal. What matters is the results of your next blood glucose test. So 2 hours after you first consumed the sugar, measure and record your blood sugar again. For someone who is insulin sensitive, their body should have no problem dealing with the sugar and their readings should have returned to baseline by now. If your blood sugar is still elevated, this can be a sign of insulin resistance or even a sign that it has went beyond that and you have type 2 diabetes. The thing with this test though is, as I said earlier, insulin resistance can start before you see any impact to your blood glucose. So this one is a little bit less accurate than some of the other measurements. So even if you do pass the oral glucose tolerance test, this does not 100% mean that you are not insulin resistant. HOMA IR. As I said at the start of this video, to really find out if you're insulin resistant, you need to go to your doctor and get a blood test. So if you failed any of the previous tests or just want to be certain, it's definitely worth it to get tested. What you need to know is what your fasting blood glucose is and what your fasting insulin is. And this will give you a certain result of your insulin sensitivity. So you can ask your doctor for a HOMA IR test, which stands for Homeostatic Model Assessment of Insulin Resistance, or you can ask for a fasting glucose and fasting insulin test and input your numbers into this formula. If you already have test results with these numbers, you can input them right now. Or if you are getting tested, save this video and come back later to look at the formula. I will put timestamps on this video so you can skip ahead to this part when you have your results. A score less than 1 is optimal and shows that you are insulin sensitive. Anything over 1.9 signals early insulin resistance, and anything over 2.9 signals you are very insulin resistant. Now, if you are insulin resistant, don't panic. There is some good news, and I'm gonna get to that in just 1 second after I take a quick moment to thank today's sponsor, Squarespace. Because thanks to them, I am able to put out more videos, I'm able to put more time into those videos, and as a result, offer more free content to you. Plus, I absolutely love Squarespace and I've been using their services for years, and I think a lot of you guys would benefit from them as well. If you are not familiar with Squarespace, they are an all-in-one online platform to run your business. Everything from websites to marketing tools such as email to scheduling tools and more. Squarespace does it all. They have a wide range of beautiful and professional templates for you to choose from that are easy to customize. You do not need any experience in web design and their award-winning customer service team is available 24/7. You can start a free trial without having to enter your credit card details or anything by heading to squarespace.com/healthcoachkate. And when you love it and decide to launch, you can use code healthcoachkate to save 10% off your first order. Thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. The good news. Now, even if you are insulin resistant, there is some good news. Insulin resistance is reversible. You may have to change your diet and your lifestyle, but it is very possible to improve your insulin sensitivity and in turn, your overall health. By reducing foods that have a high insulin response, mainly carbohydrates and especially refined carbohydrates, by intermittent fasting, and by reducing the time you are sedentary on a daily basis, these things can all help you to regain insulin sensitivity. And I do have a whole video on reversing insulin resistance and the best foods you can eat, which I will link up here above and you can check out afterwards. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you were able to successfully reverse insulin resistance and how long it took you. If you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. And also, if you know someone who you think would find this video helpful, feel free to share. If you want to check out that video I mentioned about how to reverse insulin resistance and the best foods you can eat, you can find it here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you would like to check out my keto and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can check them out here. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.